Good day, everyone. When talking about kiln operation, one of the practical solutions is to focus on the clinker cooler. The first steps to run the cooler effectively is to understand how it actually works. Before we start, please read carefully this disclaimer. In short, it says that in case of damages in your plant equipment after viewing this video, I will not be held responsible for your actions. We'll start the video with reviewing theory of clinker cooler operation, and then we will run a practical exercise. A clinker cooler is primarily a box. On one side we feed in hot clinker, and on the other we collect cooled down clinker. The clinker travels along the cooler on some sort of a grate. We also expect to recover hot air for combustion. This means we have to blow air in the box, under the grate. This air will go through the grate, cool down the clinker and become very hot. We need a lot of air to cool down all this clinker. This air will create a positive pressure under the grate. But we want to keep a slightly negative pressure on top of the grate. For this, we need an additional extraction, so-called waste air. There are two main reasons to keep a negative pressure on top of the grate: to avoid blowing clinker dust outside of the cooler, and to limit the intake of false air in the system. The clinker cooler has two main controls. First, the grate speed. The faster the speed, the thinner the clinker bed, the hot clinker moving towards the discharge end. And the other way around, slower speed equal higher clinker bed. The second control relates to the amount of air blown and how it is distributed. Let's have a look at the names given to all these airs and regions in the cooler. Coming through the burner is the primary air. The hot combustion airs are called secondary and tertiary airs. Tertiary exists only with precalciners, obviously. The false air coming through the kiln hood and the discharge seal, we will check how bad this false air is, the extraction of cooling air, excess air, or waste air. There are two main zones in the cooler: the hot zone or recuperation zone, and the cold zone or after cooling zone. There are two extraction points on opposite sides of the cooler. This creates a zero zone or mid zone in the cooler as seen with the dashed line. Manufacturers design their coolers depending on the clinker tonnage to handle, the volumes of secondary, tertiary airs, the capacity and performance of cooler fans, the waste air fan, speeds of the grates, pressures under grates, till all are balanced. Knowing this, and looking at the previous scheme, this means that in theory, the best way to run the cooler would be to have a very slow grate speed, which would keep the hot clinker in the recuperation zone and achieve the best heat exchange possible. This is the theory, but let us understand how much energy can be recovered from a hot clinker. Let us talk about the cooler heat balance. We start with what we need to get into the kiln, the total clinker heat of formation. In our example, our clinker is bringing in 1500 kilojoules per kilogram. A small fraction of the energy will be lost through radiation from the cooler structure. More energy is lost through waste air and going out with a cool clinker. We can measure and calculate these losses. This means that the secondary air returning can also be calculated. To achieve the clinker heat of formation, we will need to add the difference as fuel. In terms of cooler efficiency, it would be the input minus the total losses gives us the cooler efficiency. This is just an example. A proper heat balance should be made to calculate your cooler efficiency. Earlier I talked about false air, and here it comes. false air is sucked in the system instead of the secondary air. The loss of energy will have to be compensated by additional fuel, increasing our manufacturing costs, and the waste air fan will have to suck out the excess hot air, which was displaced by the false air, to keep the hood pressure slightly negative. False air cannot be eliminated, but can be reduced. This is the first step to improving your cooler efficiency. Make sure to have a kiln discharge seal, such as these fish scales devices, and adapting a sealing ring between the burner and the hood will minimize false air intake. It is during operation that we can achieve better system efficiency. Let's have a look at what happens in the cooler. The increase of air pressures under grades has two components. First, the resistance to air flow because of the clinker bed. It is constant along the cooler since the clinker is moving at the same speed. Second, and in addition, the resistance created by the expansion of the air going through the hot clinker. This delta P expansion is a function of the clinker temperature. This means that the first fans in the cooler must be able to deliver high pressures, while the colder side of the cooler delivers volume to finish the cooling process. This also explains why the first compartments are designed much smaller than the last ones. On our earlier analysis, we saw that it would be preferable to run the grates at low speed to keep the hot clinker in the recuperation zone for as long as possible. But in such cases, the increased clinker height will increase the delta P clinker, which in turn pushes the delta expansion as well. The fans will not be able to deliver such pressures, the seals will leak, the grates will not support the additional weight. So, when do we run the cooler efficiently within the limits of the equipment? Let us have a look at the real cooler. We have seen the theory on clinker coolers. Let us run a practical exercise. Here is the kiln we will work with. Dry process, 5 stages, pre-calciner, 3000 tons per day production rate. We can see the cooler. And going into more details, notice the second air temperature at 854 Celsius, the clinker temperature at 115 Celsius. The undergrade pressure at 44 millibars. Notice that we take this reading from fan 2. It is usually done this way since pressure at fan 1 is normally unstable. Notice that there are no indication of the grade speed. They're not shown on purpose, it will make the exercises more fun. We just know that grate 1 and 2 are running at the same speed. We have a uniform clinker bed on the cooler. All the undergrade fans are running on manual mode, indicated by the M. You notice the pressure at the fan exit, the flow it delivers, and the damper position. The only auto control loop in automatic mode with the A is the waste air damper, keeping the hood pressure at 0.2 millibar. For this exercise, let's follow what changes happened and find out the cause of the change. To help you in the analysis, I marked the changes to the individual parameters. If they have gone up or down, from the normal stable operation we had before. In your opinion, what caused the changes? Have a look at all those possibilities. I recommend you to pause the video now and take some time to think what has caused the changes. You can post your answers in the comments of the video. I will reply and may post another video explaining the logic to find the cause of a change if I see that too many of you couldn't find the real reason. Thanks for watching and good luck in your deductions.